You know, just to, maybe we'll switch gears just a tiny bit, because you have reviewed the things an individual should do with MRSA, or if someone in the community, what they can be doing to protect themselves. But if there is an incident that occurs, what is a typical response, say, from a public health agency to sort of start to address that?
Well, in terms of responding to reports of MRSA, mm-hmm. public health officials or public health agencies respond to clusters or outbreaks, suspect okay. clusters or outbreaks of MRSA. Individual cases of MRSA are not reportable.
Okay.
And in response to these reports of a number of MRSA cases involving a particular jurisdiction or institution, public health officials will try to investigate, one, to find out whether or not there was actually a MRSA case that was confirmed.
Okay.
And if that is the case, they'll try to characterize the extent of the outbreak to try to figure out how many people might be involved.
Okay.
And in response to trying to control further spread of MRSA, they'll try to institute educational measures to
right,
essentially alert the public in terms of what MRSA is and what they can do to protect themselves. And
right.
that's a critical component of the public health response, since
as
we don't
a public health educator, I would agree with that.
Exactly.
Yes.
Especially since we don't have drugs or vaccine to protect people against MRSA infections.
Okay. So all of those things that you've described, and Pat, it's almost as if you're saying the same things, just applied in a different environment.
Very similar.
Right? Hand washing. Basic, good old hand washing does it. Cover your wounds, clean the surfaces. None of this is brain surgery, is it? This is really just basic, good hygiene practices.
Doing the things your mother told you to
Doing
do.
Doing the things
Absolutely.
Our mom told us, that's right, that's exactly right. So, you know, I think you're both really raising some very reassuring messages here. You know, we've reiterated the fact that it's good old basic hand hygiene and some basic infection prevention things that we can all do to reduce our risks of infection. My question is, or my comment, and I'd like your feedback on this, is that because of all of the media hype that we've heard over these last few months, and I'm not minimizing the concern by any means, and we realize there has been fatalities associated with this, but do you feel as though the media has potentially made it appear as if this is something new, and therefore has caused a heightened concern amongst the public? I mean, are you seeing that in
well,
patients
I think
who
definitely,
come in?
I mean, I get phone calls frequently from
okay.
community members asking about MRSA and stuff
right.
in the community. And MRSA has been around, as I mentioned earlier, since the mid-70s, and
okay.
it is newer in the community over the last few years, certainly.
Right.
Most MRSA infections, and I'm sure Corey would probably agree with this, are treatable skin infections. It is
okay.
the rare occasion that you have the significant severe disease
mm-hmm.
That causes and leads to death in
right.
the community.
Right.
And it's an infection that we in the healthcare setting have been dealing with, you know, since
For
the
quite
70s.
Some time. Right.
Although we're seeing more of it, we are not seeing more severe disease in the healthcare setting than
okay.
we've seen previously.
Okay.
We just have seen an increased number of cases.
In quantities, right.
Exactly.
Now, are you getting increased phone calls as well at the state health department?
Yeah, during the fall of this year, we saw a huge increase in the number of phone calls from people who were concerned about
mm-hmm.
MRSA.
Right.
And just to underscore what Pat had just mentioned, MRSA is not anything that's new.
Right.
And I think one of the things that is reassuring to the public is that there are things that they can do to prevent themselves from coming down with an infection,
right.
not just MRSA, and one of those bread and butter activities
right.
is
right.
washing your hands.
Exactly, exactly. Well, thank you both for joining us today and for reiterating all of these very basic, important reminders. We will be sharing with all of our viewers all of this information that you've shared, and I know, Corey, there are several resources that the State Health Department offers,
too?
Yes,
we have some educational resources that
okay.
are available on our website, things
okay,
like
great.
A MRSA fact sheet and brochures that can
Excellent.
Help in terms of educating the public about MRSA infections.
Excellent. So we will have that information as well as any of the backup references that you have made. I think that would be very useful to our viewers to be able to just delve into this a little bit deeper. Well, thank you both so much for joining us today and sharing your time and expertise on this very important topic. And we would also like to thank our viewers for joining us for Public Health Matters and remind you that you can visit the Middlebrook Regional Health Commission's website to look at all of the resources that we've been sharing with you today. And that website is www.middlebrookhealth.org. www.mercyhealth.org. And thank you all for joining us.
Keep good health in the spotlight. Remember to cover your cough or sneeze with a tissue or your elbow and wash your hands frequently throughout the day. These simple actions help keep everyone healthy.
Hi, how are you doing today?
It looks good.
Our special today is shrimp scampi. It's been sitting around for about a week.
Excuse me, what time are you guys leaving? We're gonna rob your house tonight.
Don't you wish there were warnings to protect you from life's risks? With diabetes, there is one. It's called A1C, a simple blood test that helps measure your risk of a heart attack and other complications. Learn more at diabetesa1c.org.